Ever had an important event coming up and bam, huge zit in the middle of your forehead? I hate when that happens. Hello, cutest wearers. Lisette here for DNews. Acne vulgaris, also known as those annoying, painful, oozing red bumps or dark dots on your skin, is something that affects almost all of us, especially during our teenage years. But what causes acne in the first place and why is it so difficult to treat? Well, there are a ton of different ideas out there, ranging from hormones to diet to our genetics and even psychological reasons like stress, which might explain that pimple before prom. Although little is known for certain, some of these hypotheses do have more support than others. One surprising new study published in May 2016 in the journal Cell blamed your DNA. Scientists from Yale took blood samples of three individuals suffering from acne and discovered that all three samples of DNA had mutations within the gene NEK9. This gene is responsible for hair follicle production on your skin, but this mutation causes a defect in the follicle, which makes it produce large blackheads and acne instead of normal hair. According to lead researcher Dr. Keith A. Coate, all acne is dependent upon hair follicles, so it makes sense to look at the genes responsible for hair production in our search for what causes acne. It's an exciting new path of study. Now, the Yale researchers looked at one specific type of acne called Nevus comedonicus, but a meta review of many studies on different types of acne seems to suggest that your mom and dad might be the problem. The review found that acne's heritability is actually around 80% for first-degree relatives, so if your parents had acne, chances are you will too. Another potential culprit might be naturally occurring bacteria in your body. While research is unclear, there is some evidence that bacterial organisms like Propionibacterium, a common bacteria found on your skin, might cause acne. Some evidence that lends credence to this argument is that researchers have found that antibiotics can sometimes help with decreasing acne, but they're not really sure if it's the antibiotics' anti-inflammatory or antibacterial properties that are doing the job. So it could be that inflammation is the problem and not bacteria. But again, no one knows for sure. A common idea is that diet can wreak havoc on your skin. Many people swear that certain foods like chocolate or butter cause them to break out. And hey, everybody's different. This may be the case for you. But when it comes to scientific experiments, the evidence to back this up is lacking. A meta review conducted by scientists at the University of Nottingham Center of Evidence-Based Dermatology looked at many studies that considered the relationship between diet and acne. Altogether, they found only one study showed what you eat makes a difference. A diet low in glucose seems to be associated with better skin, but this is definitely not enough to make conclusions, so treat yourself. This lack of research and understanding, as well as the fact that there are different types of acne with potentially different causes behind them, makes it so tricky to treat. There's likely never going to be one silver bullet that cures it all. Luckily for most of us, acne goes away after our 30s. On top of this, most acne, as uncomfortable as it may be, is largely benign. So while it might ruin your day, it's probably not going to last forever. To learn more about why acne evolved and how it may benefit us from an evolutionary perspective, check out Tara's episode here.
They refer to acne as a high-order psychoneuroimmune interaction that functions to ward off potential mates until a person is past the age of reproductive maturity and thus emotionally, intellectually, and physically fit to be a parent.
If you've ever had acne, what have you found helps? Share your thoughts in the comments below and remember to subscribe so you never miss an episode of DNews. Thanks for watching, guys.